Moving along with the pulse of the community, it's time to start thinking about phenomenal women. Now, everybody knows that that's all I talk about, are phenomenal women, because I'm such a promoter of women and what we do and how we do it and where we do it and the excitement that we have when we're doing it. And one of the most amazing women that I think I've talked to, she's been on my show before, and she does an amazing thing for Los Angeles. It's Faye Washington. She's back with us. Last time she was here, she was talking about this huge building that she dreamed of that was going to open in 2012. And here we are in 2012, and I think I'm talking to her at that building. Am I right, Faye?
Yes, you are. I have to exit Cloud 9 to come down for this conversation. But yes.
Yes. It's so good to have you back, and I'm so proud of you and everything that you've done. Tell us just a little bit about YWCAGLA.
YWCAGLA is this phenomenal organization, and our focus is, of course, women, the community, things that make the community click, things that keep us whole, and we are just in the community with child care, with sexual assault crises training. And then lastly, we're about the economy. We're about economics, teaching individuals how to graduate from high school, how to get a job, how to get a career and move forward in that career. And we've done so with this phenomenal building that we have just completed. And this week, we're in the building now. And this week, on Thursday, we will be moving over 400 at-risk youth ages 16 to 24 in this building. And it feels so good.
Oh, man. And just, you know what? God bless you for everything that you are doing. And one of the most fun things that you do that I get to be a part of are the 2012 Phenomenal Woman of the Year Awards. This is an incredible ceremony going on. Let's talk about when it is, where it is, and why it is.
The event is scheduled for May 16th. It will occur at the Omni Los Angeles Hotel, the California Plaza, 251 South Olive Street. And it's a time at which we pause to recognize the phenomenal women in our community, of which we have many. They come from corporations. They come from businesses. They come from government. They're from everywhere because phenomenal women are everywhere. But most importantly, we pause to salute a phenomenal woman. And this year, our theme is saluting women who inspire change. And when we came to that theme, I immediately thought of a young woman that I had recently met, didn't have the occasion to know her in depth, but knew about the work she has done, LaFonza Butler. She has truly inspired me to keep going, keep moving forward, because she's one of those rare human beings, rare jewels, that puts aside herself and think about the will of others. And we're honoring LaFonza Butler this year because she has truly inspired change, I guess, in the lives of over 180,000 long-term care workers and nursing home workers. Those are the lives that she touched. And that's our community. Josepha, that's
wow.
Our community.
Yes, it is, most definitely. And, you know, we are so honored to have LaFonza on the phone with us this morning. Good morning, LaFonza.
Good morning, Josepha. Good morning, Miss Washington.
Good morning. Thank
you guys so much. Just listening to Miss Washington talk about the great work of YWCA GLA just inspires me all over again this morning, Josepha. Good morning. Great to be with you and all the listeners.
Well, it's great to have you here. So how does it feel that you have been called the 2012 Phenomenal Woman of the Year? I mean, you've got an incredible bio. Being over there is one of 25 international presidents of the SEIU, and at a very young age, too.
A very young age, Josepha. Look, it feels phenomenal. I admire the work that Faye Washington has done throughout the city of Los Angeles in our communities, touching the lives of parents and children, the young people over there that are part of the Job Corps program. It's just incredible. I had the opportunity to visit Faye and her operation before they moved into the new building. I'm excited to get into the new building and take a look myself. But it really does feel phenomenal to be recognized from a woman that I just respect so much, and to know that she thinks that I have something to offer to Los Angeles and to the community as much as she does, just continues to make my heart beam with admiration and with pride. And I can only hope to honor the recognition by continuing to make contributions to the lives of working families and doing my part to make our community stronger.
So tell me, what is one of the most difficult things about running or being a head figure in an organization like a union? And do you believe that unions are still as strong in America? Now, I'm a union baby. My dad was UAW, so I'm a big union believer. But talk to me about how that has changed.
So taking the first question, Josefa, the hardest thing about serving in a role like this, really you get to see income inequality each and every day. I get to work on behalf of women, my organization that represents the 180,000 home care and nursing home workers across the state of California, is 95% women. Women are caregivers, and I get to work with these incredible women each and every day and work on their behalf. And I, in doing that, get to see and experience the income inequality that exists in our country on a real, real level. I have members who, in their before life happened to them, whether their mother got ill or their child was in a car accident or they were experiencing a career change, they were scientists. They have college degrees in economics. They are former LAUSD school teachers. And to see them now in a position where they are giving all that they can to the person for whom they are providing care and not have the quality of life that our community should be affording them is incredibly difficult. It is incredibly difficult, and it is a great responsibility to represent them with the pride and dignity with which they do their work and provide the care that is needed for the person that they are providing care for. And to the question of, are unions still relevant? As long as income inequality exists in our country, unions are relevant. Unions, over the life and history of the United States, have been the constant equilibrium, if you will, in workers getting to the middle class. You said your father was a member of the UAW. Well, before those jobs were unionized by the UAW, those workers weren't sending their kids to college. They weren't. They didn't have the ability to buy homes and to make the Michigan economy great. And I think that as long as we still have the problem of income inequality, workers will always need to gather their collective strength to have a voice on their job and to create a sense of equality and equilibrium in their workplace.
Very good. Well, I am a huge supporter of unions, and I will always fight for them and because of them, because I am a member of the union and believe so strongly in what unions stand for and what they do. And just believe that in a country like ours, we couldn't need it more. So thank you for doing your part in being one of the 25 international presidents of SEIU. Now, do you ever get to travel internationally?
I do. I have, you know, I say often, I have gotten to travel the world on behalf of workers, and it has been an incredible privilege and an absolute honor to work with workers in South Africa, in Malawi, in China and Japan, in countries in and throughout Europe. You know, our economy really has become global, as we experienced in 2007 and 2008 with the economic crash that started here in the United States but really had impact worldwide. And employers are multinational. And the more that labor unions start to recognize that the only barriers that exist are those that we create. You know, boundaries don't exist in our economy, and neither should worker power and worker strength. And I've done a lot of work in my career trying to connect workers who work for multinational corporations here in Los Angeles, even, as security officers were organizing, and connect those workers to the security officers that were organizing in South Africa, and unite that power across borders so that workers could have a united voice, truly, not just in one state that we might be working on.
Well, congratulations. It's very obvious why you have been chosen as the 2012 Phenomenal Woman of the Year. And I look forward to meeting you. I'll be your MC that day. So I look forward to seeing you May 16th at the Omni, 251 South Olive Street. Now, Faye, give us a website where we can go for more information about all the incredible work, because you are the ultimate phenomenal woman, Faye. We all want to grow up and be just like you.
Be better. The website that you can reach us on is www.ywcagla.org.
And the event, you can get tickets for the event at the website?
Absolutely. Tickets are available, and they're available right now. You can pick them up and come meet this wonderful, inspiring young woman.
And all the other fabulous women, because talk about a room full of phenomenal women.
Yes.
This event is so incredible. Bring your business cards and be ready to pass them out, shake a hand, and make a friend.
Absolutely.
Because this is the premier event to be at for women everywhere. May 16th, Omni Hotel, 251 South Olive, www.ywcagla.org is where you can go get more ticket information on the event. Come on out there and meet LaFonza. Shake a hand and meet one of the most amazing ladies you'll ever meet, Faye Washington, who is changing the lives of hundreds and hundreds and thousands of youth in Los Angeles every single day. Ladies, it's my honor to have you both here this morning, and I can't wait to see you both on the 16th of May. As we keep our pulse on the community, we are going to be getting together and changing lives. How do we do that? With a mentor recruitment day. It's a step towards assisting juvenile youth being released from juvenile camps and prisons. The event is hosted from 1 to 4 p.m. Saturday, April 28th. So that's next Saturday at the City of Refuge, 14527 South San Pedro in the city of Gardena. It's a mentoring recruiting day set up by a local group of churches. And I tell you what, they're doing some amazing work. And with us to talk about it today, Jason, who is a Pathways coach and mentor, Melody, a Pathways coach and mentor, and Lisa is with PV Jobs. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning. Good morning.
It is so good to have you here. So let's get right down to it. What is this mentoring day all about? How does one become involved if they want to come out and be a mentor that day? And then what is the commitment after that?
The mentoring recruitment day, like you said, is on April 28th. And the day is solely to recruit mentors that have a heart to serve the youth that have been impacted by the criminal justice system. A lot of the youth that are coming out of the prison camps are coming home on broken pieces. And they're coming home and they don't know where to go. They don't have any resources as far as jobs, as far as home and family life goes. And so what the mentors are going to do is kind of guide them and help them to be a lifeline for them.
Right.
On the mentoring recruitment day, the whole day is geared to give information to the mentors to let them understand exactly who they're dealing with. So the mentors that will be at the mentoring recruitment day will get a better understanding of what it means to deal with those that are coming out of prison, kind of get rid of the myths of people coming out of prison and they're hardcore and they don't
want any help.
They don't want any help.
They really do most of the time.
In actuality, they're begging for help.
Exactly.
So these mentors that we are recruiting, we will teach them how to speak to the mentees that are coming out, how to relate to them, how to listen to them, and how to direct them to where they need to be. So on April 28th, between 1 and 4 p.m. at the City of Refuge, we're looking to recruit as many mentors as we can so that we can help guide these youth that are coming out so they don't go back into the prisons.
Exactly. Lisa, tell me your involvement.
Well, I work at PV Jobs and UJCC, which is hosting the Mentor Recruitment Day. They are partners of ours. PV Jobs works on getting adults really back into the jobs area after they get out of prison. Usually it's hard, especially for felons, to find
a gig. To find a job. Yeah, you know? It really is.
And about the only industry that is felony friendly is the construction industry. And PV Jobs works primarily with construction industry folks who are willing to hire people who have come out of the prison system just because they're hard workers. They can work outside. They don't have to work involved with children or anything like that. They are working with their hands. They're putting up buildings. They're tearing down buildings. And they're doing different things in the construction industry. And that's what PV Jobs is all about.
Very good. Is there a website for PV Jobs?
PVJobs.org.
That's an easy one. PVJobs.org for people who want more information on that.
Exactly.
And so you're just kind of helping facilitate this whole day and get people encouraged to come out.
Exactly. Well, P3, the Positive Pathways Program, is one of PV Jobs programs. We got a grant, and this P3 program is where we have juvenile offenders, I guess 18 through 24, persons who have come out of the juvenile camps and come out of the prisons. And this is, again, to help them get on the right pathway. And you'll read more about P3 on our website, pvjobs.org.
Okay, Melody, talk to me about being a Pathways coach and mentor.
Yes, I'm a Pathways coach for the Positive Pathways program, which is the P3 program that Lisa was just talking about. We work with youth ages 16 to 24 that are living in certain service areas and have come out of the juvenile camps. We've already started going into the camps and meeting with some of the young people that are coming out soon and helping them figure out what their goals will be and trying to help them get there. And we work with them one-on-one for 1 year. And we are there to guide them throughout all their ideas, whether educational goal or academic career advice. And so we do the assessment with them. We just try to find out what their needs are. And some of the young people, they might not have homes. They might be homeless. We, make sure that they have all the resources within the community to get to where they need to be.
Because a lot of times I think that it's not for lack of desire to do better, but it's lack of information on how to do better. And if you don't have somebody who can present to you what your resources are, you don't know what to do and you find yourself lost and you go with what you know. And sometimes what you know isn't the right thing, And that's why information is so important. And I can't thank you both enough for making sure
that these kids have access to the information. Because I used to work in juvenile hall, so I have an idea, and I truly believe that for the most part, these kids are really just looking for somebody to show them the way.
Yeah. And now it's a matter of getting the information to them about the resources and resources like this. And being a mentor to these young people, I don't think that people understand what a difference that can really make in someone's life, being a mentor. And it doesn't take a whole lot of time. What kind of time commitment are we looking at?
They just need to meet with their mentee 8 hours a month and once a week. It could be through email, a phone call. It doesn't have to be, like you said, it doesn't have to be this intense time. They just have to be there for the young people. They just need someone to talk to sometimes to get them on the right path and give them other options outside of what they're normally doing.
And it doesn't take long, because as adults, we have a lot of resources. We might not even realize how many resources we have, but those resources could make a difference in the life of a kid. It really could. And I know everybody's got time to send an email, to make a phone call. And 8 hours a month, come on, that's an afternoon. A couple afternoons in a month, or one whole day, or 2 hours a week to change the life of a young person. So if this is something that's interesting to you and you might want to be involved with it, the United Job Creation Council is having the Mentoring Recruiting Day set up by a group of local churches. It's all happening Saturday, April 28th, 1 to 4 p.m. at the City of Refuge Church. I'll make sure that address is up on my webpage at hot923.com. Keyword Josefa, along with the web address for PV Jobs, which is simple, pvjobs.org. Is there a web address for United Job Creation Council?
Yes, unitedjobcreationcouncil.org. You can also like us on Facebook. On our photo cover, you will find the mentor recruitment flyer for the mentor recruitment day.
Very good. Well, thank you for coming down. Mikasa Sukasa, my mic is your mic. Whenever you guys have something going on, please come down and share it with me. And if I had room to mentor one more person, I would definitely be there. But I've got like 15 kids right now that I'm mentoring. And just people know always, and I'm saying this to all of you as well, I'm a resource with vast resources. If there's anything that I can do to help you, let me be of assistance to you. Or if there's a kid that you're trying to look for something, you can't quite find somebody that might have the answer, know that I'm here, that I can be the umbrella mentor on top of the kids that I do mentor. Definitely, you have that, my commitment to that, to your program.
Thank you.
Great. Thank you so much.
All right. And good luck on the program. Again, it's April 28th, 1 to 4 p.m., City of Refuge. They're looking for you to mentor. Come on down and at least see what it's all about, or go to the websites. The Hot Squad will be down there at this event, so get out there and find out what being a mentor is all about. Change your life, and guess what? I will guarantee you that more than likely, it's your life that'll be changed. All the resource information from today is up on my webpage at hot923.com, keyword Josefa. And if you want to share this interview with somebody, guess what? It'll be up on YouTube, youtube.com/Josefa Salinas. Look for the official Josefa Salinas channel. I am Josefa Salinas. Until we get together again, stay strong, stay focused, and most of all, stay informed. I'll see you next Sunday on the Community Review, Hot 92.3. Get out there and enjoy your day. I'm headed out to St. John Bosco. I'm a track coach. My kids are running today. I'm right there with you. Let the wind be beneath your feet.